What's up guys, this is Sean and today we are in Main Place, USJ. Yeah, let's go. Hey guys, so now we are at the entrance of the mall itself. So you can see McDonald's, Starbucks, and the entrance is pretty busy where you have cars parked roadside. Malaysians being Malaysians, and not only that, right? Those days when this project was abandoned, back in the days, all these shops were dying. And now you can see that you have all different types of makan place, salon, convenience stores, and etc. All are doing very, very well. I'm now walking from Main Place towards the USJ 21 train station, right? And you can see that there's actually a built shade for people to actually walk, although it's low. Just to keep it very cost effective, right? If in a rain, very heavy rain, I doubt that it will do anything. So some background about USJ, it's a very well done and matured township where you can have basically populations with diverse background and income levels. So you have the Goodyear courts from those days, right? Then you have the industrial areas, you have the terrace houses, the super big commercial areas like Taipan. And one very special thing about USJ as well is that there's a lot of public schools. And then you have the Taylors, the Sunway, the Monash, the Inti, and etc. Subang and USJ, for those locals, they say it's different, but to outsiders, right, it's basically in the same area, just divided and separated by Kersas Highway lah. And I'm currently very excited because in this project, right, we will see a few different things. Like, number one is that how abandoned projects get revitalized. So number two, what's the importance of software versus hardware? Meaning like malls are everywhere nowadays, but what's important is the leasing department of the mall itself. Do you get the right tenant mix? And how can that actually drives the whole neighboring shop lots to be alive again, right? Number three, the difference between designs, like back then, how was houses like, how was designs being done? And last of all, abandoned projects last time can buy me. How is it inside can stay me? I think now let's go to the mall first. Coming up from the lift itself, you can see it's actually like a journey back in time. Condition is actually pretty run down. You look at the structural columns and beams and things like that, all across the units. Then also you can find very old school windows. Wow, it's been a while since we actually find this. I also forgot what this window are called really. This one is like only can be found in hipster cafes nowadays. Then the refuel chamber is located right next to the lift lobby itself. And you can see this is the... Ooh, it smells bad. You have your pipe wash, right? So that's about it. So at least you have ventilation. Coming into the unit, I think it's a rather direct unit where you can see almost everything already. Your dining, your living, and your bedrooms really. And that's your kitchen. So in one glance, you can see almost everything really. But before that, let's get through the specs first. This is a 615 square feet, 2 bedroom, 1 bathroom unit. And this was developed before the MRT actually kickstarted. And you can actually see the design is actually old design where there's only 1 bathroom. And the lifestyle actually changed where residents have reprioritized privacy. So now like terrace house or condo, so you can see a lot of bathrooms. Also, before I forget, shout out to Cozy Home for actually allowing me to tour around their listing. And it's a platform where people can rent all fully furnished units in Klang Valley itself. So if you want to know more, just check out the website down below and let's continue with the tour. Back then when this was abandoned, right, that was the time where a lot of projects around Malaysia also got abandoned. And that's when I think the government actually set up this HDA that actually protects consumers. So it also means that when a company registers to be a developer or they want to launch a certain project, right, they must open an account, a joint account with the housing development authorities. So whatever money that goes through or earns via the project all must go to this account first. And they also need to put in a hefty capital in order to be registered as a developer prior to any work done. So not far away, UHJ19 has also one of the mall that was abandoned as well. And that one also got refurbished. This one is a very classic example, right, of software versus hardware. UHJ19 mall, right, is next to the main road, where this one, right, you still need to access further in. But the huge success of this revitalization of this building itself, right, I think would be credited to all the leasing team. You have all Starbucks, McDonald's, Uniqlo, and the choices for food. It's a very complete neighborhood mall, and you can also see the effect actually improves the entire economy around the shop lots here. Okay, one key observation is you can see the ceiling height is rather low. It's around 2.8 meters only, and you can see the columns are huge. You can look at this column. Okay, and then also adopt this those days like those slanted columns as well. Okay, so this is your fridge. Pantry, we'll call it pantry because it's not big enough where you can do your dai chao, you know. Okay, so there will be a common bathroom, master bedroom, and your smaller bedroom. Let's check out the master bedroom first. Okay, walking into the master bedroom, this is a queen size bed and you can still have a lot of space for circulation. Again, from the structural elements, right, it's very thick, so the circulation space kind of got restricted. But on this side, the corridor is very nice lah. Okay, then you have your wardrobe. And the issue here for a lot of like modern house buyers, right, is that there's only one bathroom shared between two rooms and the public, so it's one toilet only. Okay, divided by a sliding door, you will have your toilet, then you have your basin, you have your WC and shower area. You can actually tell the age of the building, right, via the flooring. So tile sizes are actually smaller because of the manufacturing restrictions, but now we can have like 1 meter by 1 meter, right? It's quite common these days. How they categorize nice tiles is less groove, meaning, right, I use bigger tiles, then I have less joints between, so I have less lines. Yeah, that was a thing lah. Going on to the smaller bedroom, this is also a queen size bed, your wardrobe, and I think that's about it. Okay, let's check out what is here. Oh, this is the pit for the airwell above. So I think you will find some rubbish here. Sure got rubbish. So it's actually divided by this very old school type of window. Next to the kitchen, let's check out the yard. That's where you put your washing machine. Okay, and you can look at these slanted columns. Right, that gives the very weird kind of kink and angles, right? Then you have your M&E running very weirdly. Also pretty common for older projects, right, where tiles at the kitchen area is only around 1.5 meters high. So this is an afterthought of the aircon bracket. So this one, right, is actually pulled into the toilet ceiling. That's why usually in toilets, there will be another layer of plaster ceiling to actually hide out all the wiring and conduits, right? Also, before I forget, if you look into the property portals, like this unit itself is actually selling for 300 plus, like 320, 350 also got, based on the furnishings and the different levels, right? And for rent, this fully furnished is actually asking for 2000 ringgit per month. So if you calculate the return, but if you buy previously, like the previous owners, right, they went through a very tremendous journey where they actually buy already, then when the developer built halfway, then abandoned the project. And actually Bina Puri came and take over and revitalized this project. It has been a roller coaster, right? And this is the risk, right, for previous house buyers before the government actually stepped in to protect them. So it's not as luxury as now. Again, we all take for granted lah. So we are now in the barbecue area, and in one glance, right, it looks pretty awesome, very decent, very green, very early, right? Now we are in the letterbox area. It
It's pretty cool though, but you can still see that the very low ceiling.
Hey guys, so I think that's all for the visit. It's now time for Sean take 3 on 3. 3 things I really like. Number one, the revitalization process of the entire project. Because very kasihan all those initial buyers lah. But what's the most impressive part of this is actually the leasing team for the mall downstairs. You can see the comparison between this and USJ 19 mall and the One City Mall. 3 or so mall. And that time the saying was, hey, 3 or so mall, which one should I buy? And because of the right mix, the right tenant mix, right, this area actually kaboom, which is awesome. Next would be the location itself in USJ 21. So USJ, right, is a very well-balanced township where you have the Goodyear courts those days, right, from the very affordable range to this kind of apartments, then to the terrace houses, to ultra, semis and bungalows, those super high-end. Not only that, you have a lot of schools here because the environment here is actually very, very matured and it's very suitable for families where you can find all convenience you need. You need tuition center, lah, piano, lah, makan, lah, minum, lah, hangout place, lah, a lot. Lah. And Taipan is one of those areas, right, just like SS15, where those days, before e-banking time, Taipan was very famous because of all the banks they have. And that is only like 10 minutes away. Not only that, you can actually access to the highway via the back. So you can actually go Puchong on this side, or you can go NKVE via the other side. Or you need to go to Sunway direction, but that Persiaran Kewajiban then will have a lot of traffic lights and cars lah. And the bonus part now, the MRT, the USJ 21 station is actually up and running. Last of all would be the convenience of living. So if I were to stay here, right, I don't need to drive out anymore from work. Right, I actually commute via the train and I come down and I can actually have the mall. If that's not enough, I want some old school shop office, kopitiams or mamaks, right, I can just walk. If those are not enough, I see one more thing, I can just drive out to Taipan, I can drive out to Puchong, or I drive out to Summit Mall and etc. So all those, right, at a price that is so affordable. Okay, the first point that I don't like, number one, is actually the old designs. So the old design of architectural and mechanical and structural, you can see it's very evident in this project itself. What I mean is, number one, columns are weird. In really pure position, and ceiling height is capped to 2.8. Then going into the unit, a 2-bedroom unit can only have 1 bathroom, so you need to share with your guests. That's where the master bedroom then become not so luxurious, because anyone in the house use your bedroom, right, you will be disturbed. Second thing I don't like would be the corridors and the lift lah. But I understand this is adopted from the previous developer when it was abandoned. Sense of arrival to the unit, right, is just very unpleasant. Last of all would be the traffic in this area. Again, USJ is a very mature development, that's why there's a lot of population here. But you can look at the series of traffic lights, right, from Summit right over to this USJ 21, right, there's just a lot of traffic light, a lot of junctions, and you can see the cars, right, never ending. In this episode, as you can see, the translation of design across time, meaning like now you can see windows are no longer those panel type, now it's actually fixed aluminium type. You can see ceiling heights are different now, room requirements are different. Also, you will learn that this project was abandoned before, and after reviving, it's actually livable. It's not as crazy. Ayo, later the structural will fail because it was not done really well. No such thing lah. And if you really like this video, like it, share it, and even subscribe for more information like this. Until next time, this is Sean Tan. Ciao.